Southampton move into the top six again after beating Leeds 4-0. Kevin Keegan, with his 14th goal of the season, opened the scoring with yet another penalty. Leeds have sent assistant manager Martin Wilkinson to South America to watch 24-year-old Peruvian international Julio Uribe, who, if he impresses, could be involved in an exchange deal with Alex Sabella, who's keen to return to South America now that he can't command a first team place at Elland Road.
The undersoil heating at Elland Road, which was switched on Tuesday, has done its job well, and Leeds United's directors estimate that since it was installed 10 years ago, it saved the club thousands of pounds on days like these. There's Trevor Cherry in the right back position, which he doesn't particularly like playing in. He's been forced there since the arrival of Kenny Burns. Continue his run and he'll go right at the heart of the Spurs defence. What a magnificent run! Oh, that really deserved the goal. Superb run from Arthur Graham. Butterworth got Hurd wide on the right, eventually manages to find him. Butterworth's a tryer, no doubt about that. And there's a cross which Butterworth could get to, and Clements, well, he took it well under the challenge. That's why he's one of England's top two goalkeepers. Leeds United start the second half with substitute Terry Connor on in place of Aidan Butterworth. The news from the dressing room is that Butterworth has a badly bruised hip. Stevenson finds Graham, who's switched to the right wing, which is often where he's been at his best this season. Here's Hampson. Oh, and a cracking drive from Hampson and the save of the match from Clements. Gary Hampson really hits it well, and he did then. It's all over. At the end of a rather fruitless day for both sides in many ways, but at least we had some football. It's a goalless draw.
Volunteers and snow-clearing machines are being used on the terraces and car parks as well as the pitch, which has the benefit of undersoil heating. But by Saturday, this heating will have cost them £4,000 for the week's work. Leeds United are seriously wondering whether it's all worthwhile, when the likelihood of a low attendance means they're going to lose money in any case. They need a crowd of more than 30,000 to break even. Last season, only 19,000 turned up for the same fixture.
Leeds are the only club of the 22 unbeaten at home this season. Indeed, you have to go back 13 matches to last March to find their last defeat against Wolves.
Burns picking out Eddie Gray. Again, the skill there, that lovely little pass to Hampson. And the other Gray. And back to Eddie.
Oh, good ball for Arthur Graham inside the box, getting the cross in. Oh, and here comes Stevenson. Surely. Oh, he took that well. Well, it's been threatening, and it is a perfect goal. This good skill, first of all, by Eddie Gray. The clip along the line from Hampson, and just look at Gray's control as he nicks the ball inside to Arthur Graham, who is causing all sorts of problems. Gets inside the box. I thought he might have been brought down. He tucks it away to Byron Stevenson, and from the most acute of angles, the Welshman scores.
Free kick for Leeds. The two-man wall being told to retreat further as Butterworth makes a run in the hope of meeting this cross from Gray. It's useful. Paul Hart's up there, and Butterworth scores!
2-0. The Swansea defenders hold their heads because they left Paul Hart totally unmarked on the far post, and it might be a moot point as to whether Hart or Butterworth claim the goal. The important thing is the ball's in the net. Frankie Gray hoisting the perfect free kick, and just look at the room that Paul Hart finds himself in at the far post. There he is, and Aidan Butterworth, a touch from no more than a yard.
Alan Clark, who, well, he looks a little bit pensive, but he'll be happy with 3 points today.
And there, in fact, goes the final whistle, blown by Mr. Wilson. A very meritorious win for Leeds United. Swansea never really wanted to play this game, and they didn't show any heart for the fight at all this afternoon. Byron Stevenson the first, and there's Aidan Butterworth, who celebrated this 2-0 victory with his third goal in seven games.
Paul, what a combination you two fellas look today. You really enjoyed it, and for a big fella, you kept your feet so well.
Thank you very much. It's yes, I did enjoy it. It was, the conditions weren't as bad as I first thought it, and I thought we adapted better today.
And what about yourself, really, with Leeds? Do you think really they can start going up the table?
Yeah, I'll find something to do something. You know, I've said in papers, you know, to the public that I fancy it's for Europe, and I still believe it.
Leeds United have steadily improved in recent weeks and are nobody's pushovers.
Knocked away by Roberts. And some desperate arguing now going on between the players. Eddie Gray's incensed. Roberts isn't happy. Moves out of the way, Frankie Gray. Oh, a good hit and a good save by Clements. Leeds worked the free kick so well. Stevenson stood in front of the ball and Frankie Gray hit it through, and Clements had to produce a good save. 'Falco lifting his arms there. Crooks! Good save by Lukic. A point-blank header for Garth Crooks. Where was the defender to deny him that? Via Hazard. Has he done enough? Galvin surely nods it back for Crooks. What a terrific goal by Tottenham. Frankie Gray. Arthur Graham was onside. Oh, Butterworth threw himself at that. He'd only needed a touch. Burns. Byron Stevenson, this is Trevor Cherry, who's looking up. Paul Hart! The goal yawned big and wide. The big man, Paul Hart, got in the header, but didn't direct it well enough. Gray with the free kick for Leeds. looking for Paul Hart, who fell down. There's the final whistle.
What really have been the basis of those problems then?
A number of things really. The way results have gone, the system's changed, tactics have changed, and therefore I've been left in the cold a little bit.
But some of the fans are saying that he has been a bad buy. I mean, he's not been in the first team.
Well, he's only been here 5 minutes. As you know, or you should know, it takes longer than 5 minutes to a new player to settle into a club and a team.
Worthington now from Galvin Taylor, and Worthington, and what a beauty!